Hello and welcome to Nikolai's Genetics Lessons, and today I have prepared two very easy multiple choice questions for you. And here is the first question. As a result of fertilization, which of the following normally occur? Answer A. A gamete is created. Answer B. A single sperm and ovum combine the genetic material to create offspring with the same number of chromosomes as parents. And answer C. The final phase of the spermatogenesis is begun. And correct answer would be answer B. So we have egg cell, we have sperm cell, and sperm is much smaller than egg cell, and when these two cells, that is both 1N and 1N, meaning haploid, when they would join, merge, and would create a zygote, that is going to be 2N. So together they would make a zygote that is going to be 2N, or going to be diploid. And answer A, gamete is created. Actually, each of these cells, both egg cell and sperm, we call gamete. And these two gametes, when they merge, would create a zygote. And spermatogenesis is just a process by which sperm cells are produced. And next question. Approximately how many boys are born for every 100 girls in the United States? And three answers to choose from. And the correct answer would be answer B. Almost in any nation we have more boys born than girls. Approximately 105 boys per 100 girls. And explanation is, imagine that this is X chromosome, and females has two X chromosomes, and males has one X chromosome that is large and one small Y chromosome. So now imagine that males produce two types of sperm. One can be XY, and another type can be XX. And of course, plus 21 autosomes, so two sex chromosomes plus 21 autosomes. And we call autosomes all the chromosomes that is not sex chromosomes. So sperm would be haploid, and as you see, sperm that would be XX would have two large X chromosomes, and sperm that is going to be XY would have one large chromosome, and another chromosome would be small, and the rest 21 chromosomes would be of the same size in both sperm that is XX and XY. That makes sperm that is XY to be more motile, because it's going to be a little bit smaller, a little bit lighter than XX, just because of this difference. And of course, sperm that is slightly smaller, slightly lighter, and move a little bit faster than XX sperm. And that allows this type of sperm to reach egg cell a little bit faster and more frequently. Not to much extent, but to small extent, this type of XY chromosomes reach egg cell faster than this type. But by the age 18, 20, sex ratio becomes 1 to 1. Because males has a higher mortality rate due to number of different reasons, because males usually take more risky actions, but also even at the age between 0 and 5, when there is no difference in behavior of males and females, still mortality rate of the males usually higher than those of females. So by the age of 20, we have the same ratio of sexes, and this ratio wouldn't be stable. After this, male numbers would decline faster than females. Also due to different reasons, more risky work, and due to alcohol, for example, males work more dangerous works. And of course, there is a huge loss of life in the case of the war. And all humankind history is just a history of wars. And this is all for today. Thank you for your attention. Please subscribe for my new videos that I post almost every day. Thumbs up if you like this video. Please write your comments, questions if you have any. And see you in the next video. Goodbye.